I know of. Use a single joystick and couldn't imagine what you need two for. Okay, so let's try to visualize this. Let's use our minds. I'm going to make myself a little bit bigger for this process. No, that is the jar. So big. Benny illusion ruined! There we go. I need to make that all one graphic. Where's B? Okay. Oh, Brusky! 1,000! That's 10 bucks. Thank you so much. I appreciate that. Thank you for the tip. You are brilliant, sir. Absolutely brilliant. Okay, let's visualize this together. Come with me on a spiritual adventure. So we have a joystick here. This is my left-handed joystick. This is what I use instead of a throttle. So on a throttle, what you might use for strafing is something like this hat switch that's on top. When you press it up, you press it down, you press it left, you press it right. Actually, this is my right throttle. When you press a button that is not analog, what happens is you get either a 0 or a 100% input, meaning your thrusters are either not moving or they are blasting as hard as they can. And if you want to try to get any sort of fine movements out of your thrusters, you have to sort of rapidly tap it in order to get the movement that you want. Instead, what I have done is I have attached all of my thruster movements to joystick axes, which means I can get as fine a gradient of control as I want over them. So instead of just blasting off to the right or the left or down or up, I can just sort of slowly start sliding right, as slow as I want to, or as fast as I want to. Really keep doing that. It means I can do smooth landings by sort of strafing down very, very slowly and then strafing down faster. It means I can take off really well. It means I can flow backwards really well as well. So I can maneuver my ship as precisely as possible within the confines of Star Citizen. You're not going to get finer control over this. This means you get better maneuvers and stuff over your ship as well. So I can pull off flight maneuvers that make it seem like I'm flying decoupled, like I'm flying without any sort of flight assist, simply because I'm transitioning between like forward and backward and side-to-side strafing so smoothly that you're pulling off maneuvers that it's impossible to do otherwise. It's great control. So the advantage of a joystick or a HOTAS over mouse and keyboard is you get more control over your vessel. You've got to maximize that if you want to make up the lack of, you know, mouse aiming, which is a real hindrance when you're flying head-on. So the best way that you fight a mouse user is to be as maneuverable as possible and to stay out of their line of sight while being super accurate with your joystick as well to try to bring your heavier weapons, your heavy non-gimbaled weapons to bear and try to fight that way. So it's different schools of thought, but that's the idea. Also, it's more immersive. It's a lot more fun, I think, to have two joysticks. I was a big HOTAS guy for a long time. I used a Warthog, and I couldn't imagine any sort of reason why anybody would want to use dual stick. And then I actually tried it one day because, you know, T16000M was on sale. Thought, what the hell? I'll make a video on it or something. We'll just use it. And I haven't gone back since because it's not much better. It's really good. It's kind of like flying without track IR versus flying with track IR. Once you actually try it out, you're not going to be able to go back. Good.